services provider licensing agreement, the native licensing for services providers, the native licensing for cloud, hosting, providing SaaS services, all the other software services. That licensing program was designed by Microsoft for services providers. It may be used on private cloud. It's an option, it's not an obligation. It may also be used by your end customers on the premises under very strict conditions. What is that condition? You have to manage those servers, and they may not do anything with those servers themselves. They may only use them as a part of the services that you're providing to them. There's absolutely no way that you may allow your end clients just to take SPA licenses and use them however they please. There are two governing documents for SPA, for the licensing terms and conditions. The first one is obviously the agreement itself, and then the services provider user rights documents that lists all the licensing models, metrics, calculation rules, glossary. Please bear in mind this little detail that the product availability through SPLA is much shorter than through product terms, but that's okay because that's usually the list of products that your end users would want to normally rent from you in your data centers. As a provider, you're the licensee and you sublicense these licenses to your end users. An interesting thing that not every provider knows is that SPLA licenses may also be brought to third-party data centers, even the likes of Google and Azure.